Yeah, all right,
that's
here
it.
We go,
me and
guys.
Tubbo are getting hitched. All right, let's go into game one.
And is this a button check? Okay, no, doesn't look like
nope,
a button check.
Going right into it. Really unique thing about Wii Fit Trainer, Wii Fit lives on the ledge. Like, only, I think, her and Villager are really comfortable on the ledge. Wii Fit is not too easy to gimp, and also has a lot of strong projectiles to throw out from there.
And those two projectiles, the spike and the sun salutation, are very good, you know, ledge camping tactics.
Yeah.
Or tools. And here we go. Okay, that's the PK freeze I mentioned earlier. And Shingo is going to have to rely on getting some reads on how. Oh.
Oh. He
okay.
Tried to absorb it, but it was too late. You saw that the. Actual animation started to come out, but he was just too late. Your reaction time needs to be sharper than that if you're going to keep up in this crew battle. Because Shingo, although he's playing a character that isn't super well known, look at that damage output, 28% on that sun salutation. And the real weakness of Wii Fit Trainer is that Wii Fit doesn't have too great of hitboxes, but the damage output is clean.
It really is, especially if you can get the read on sun salutation like Shingo just did right there.
Yeah.
On the other hand, he was Kosher Meatball should have healed it, and that is actually one of the tools I'd like to see him use.
Yeah.
To come back here. This is three stock, so there's definitely room for him to come back right here. Those weightbound sun salutations are so mix-upable.
This is the problem, though, is that now that he has taken a stock of sun salutation, Shingo can easily bait out the absorption. And that has some lag on it. It does have a hitbox, but it's very easy to just end up catching a Lucas using it inefficiently.
Oh, yes. And, oh,
look
the
at the damage
here. He gets the grab release. He intentionally gets the grab release to try to get the sun salutation combo. Nice shielding there from Kosher.
Oh, my God. Shingo also completely releasing the soccer ball. Oh!
Ooh,
just a little bit detached again, but that forward smash takes a stock. Kosher Meatball is back in this game.
He is, but there is a ton of extra credit onto Kosher Meatball right now. And, oh, nice way to avoid the PK fire. Dodge that. Fast falls and another sun salutation.
See, Shingo is not letting Kosher Meatball go. You think that out of all these sun salutations, Kosher Meatball would have absorbed even one of them, but Shingo is just timing them very well.
Yeah, and you'd think that he could absorb some of the spikes too, but the soccer balls aren't playing as nearly much of a role in this game. Ooh. As the sun salutations are.
Oh, Shingo going for the down air right there.
Oh my goodness.
PK freeze coming out. Shingo not rushing it right now. Gets the up air, but oh, the down smash. That's all you need.
You know, right there, he had, as soon as he rolled left, he was like, I shouldn't have done that.
Yep.
I should not have done that. And Shingo's looking incredibly on point right now with, ooh, the air combos. That soccer ball is so annoying. Oh,
the combos are flowing out of Shingo right now. And you know what? One thing you can notice that's a big difference between these two players is that Shingo, he's old school. He is playing not only some old school Smash right now, but he's a Street Fighter player. He's all about getting in those pokes, playing those footsies, making sure that he goes in with, you know, light hits. He wants to go for those tilts. He wants to go for those aerials and waiting for the right time to go for those Smash attacks. He is not taking too much damage at all here.
And he is not really taking many risks right here. He's playing fairly conservatively. He goes for the dare spike. Doesn't get it. That would have been hype.
Shingo has the field in his control right now. He's staying out of PK fire range. Shingo wants Kosher Meatball to come out right there. Ooh, the down smash, but he gets the sour spot very luckily. Oh! Shingo trying to do some tricks.
Shingo is definitely trying to style on him. He doesn't want to lose his stock, though.
Uh-oh.
Down, up, up air. Not going to hit. Oh. And, oh, he lands the PK freeze. This follow-up is going to be extremely important. Can he get anything out of it?
Oh,
nice
Shingo's
spike.
Not taking too much damage. Getting back to the stage is a pretty good spot for Wii Fit Trainer. He's very used to it.
Oh,
he's
going
to go for a throw. Nope, goes for the grab release, but platform gets in the way of anything that he had planned.
Yeah, that's going to be it. Star KO off the top is going to take the first game. Shingo living with two stocks. We're going to see who Oopsie brings out now.
Hey, he does the up smash as well.
Oh, yeah.
Two stocks.
Two stocks and a handshake.
That's the thing, man, is that sometimes you're really, really interested in, you know, taking out those stocks, putting on your combos and all that kind of stuff. In crew battles, you need to conserve your stocks and make sure that you're taking the other ones. And sometimes that leads you to, like we saw with Gosher Meatball, he was going for a lot of F smashes. He ended up getting one, taking a stock away, but he wasn't focused on being as optimized as possible because you need to get him to that high percent. Shingo had a lot of time to just hang back and wait for Gosher Meatball to come to him. Gosher Meatball, as Lucas, you have so many good combos that you can do. You can cancel your Nair into the ground, you get that grab, follow-ups continue, but he was playing a little bit too piece by piece rather than trying to go for the full combo, man.
I mean, you mentioned grabs, and grabs are the one thing he tried to go for too. Like, I feel like that's another thing he tried to fish for. Yeah. He was dashing and trying to grab, and Shingo was just like, I'm just going to spot dodge and grab you back. And that he got grabbed way too much from that.
Yeah.
But looks like it is going to be Oopsie Mally on hopping on the Captain Falcon. I assume the Captain Falcon versus Wii Fit Trainer is what we're going to see. I can tell you, I can actually tell you quite a bit about Mally's playstyle. He likes to go in, like hard in the paint, waka flaka going in. Like near to near to knee in.
Yeah.
Like this guy goes for the most ridiculous things to style on you. Like
a lot of Captain Falcon players like to go in like that. And it isn't always the best way to go about playing, being that sometimes you do have to be more defensive. You do have to kind of bring in your opponent. But, you know, sometimes going all in, you get that one good read that gives you a lot of momentum, and it can lead into your offensive style, your really aggressive style, paying off in the end. But this is Shingo we're talking about, and this guy knows a lot of matchups. It's going to be somewhat difficult, I think, for Mally to get kind of acclimated to how Shingo plays.
All right, so here we're probably going to see more of the traditional Wii Fit play style where she's camping the ledge and charging Sun Salutation, alternating between that spike. But okay, Mally getting off to a good start here. That's what I was talking about. Going for the dare off nothing just because. And he's getting out to a pretty good lead right now. And, you know, some of the best Captain Falcon players don't usually play this aggressive, but it's seeming to be working for Mally right now. Just waiting to go in. I like this. He's playing a lot more patiently right here than I'm used to seeing. Oh, nice gentleman combo. Nice read over there, and those reads are going to be incredibly important. Mixing up when you actually pull off that nair or air,
Oh my god. Yeah, Mally has been getting down some good damage. He's waiting pretty patiently to find out where Shingo is landing and then go for that pressure. Oh, he tried to go down with a knee, it looked like, but as long as he keeps Shingo away from landing on that stage, he only has two things to worry about, and he can cover both with shield. And salute the sun and the volleyball that ends up getting thrown at him.
Oh, nice combo. Up airs into the spike!
Yeah, the spike box is actually pretty big, but luckily that platform is in the way, or Mally could have lost the stock there.
Oh.
Shingo going
okay.
there. Oh, my God.
That was filthy.
Shingo waiting too long, and he goes for the ton.
Hey, let's go, Mally. Getting the ton.
This man put everything on the line right there. Taunts can be, honestly, I love them because they can put your opponent on tilt. And if you play too much,
they come right back
at you.
I was talking about Mally going in, Shingo going in.
Yep.
Oh my goodness.
Time to get bodied right there.
True combo. Oh, footstool. Okay.
Shingo already doing more than necessary. He did take a stock off of Mally there. Molly's going to be making it back there. But if Shingo can take another stock, this man will be in five stocks. Which is much more than you even need. Really, if everybody does their job, you're going home at the end of the day with a victory. Nice up smash. Shingo needs a little bit more damage.
Oh, that was a risky back air. You can see he clearly gets punished for it. That falling back air doesn't auto cancel. It's pretty fast.
Yeah.
But there is definitely some end log on there to get punished, and Captain Falcon's frame data can definitely punish that. Oh, okay.
Yeah, Shingo is baiting in Mally here. Really good SDI on the grabs right there.
100% of the time, Mally will definitely go for one of those knees or that there, and it can definitely be exploited. Nice run up and shield.
Okay, good grab right there. Mally needs to take away this stock quickly. Good thing is he has rage. He's not in too much trouble just yet when it comes down to killing, but 120%. That was 11% on the actual throw after the pummels.
Yeah, and still Shingo putting in some work right now. He is on his last stock. Oh, gets him with a dash attack. Mally gonna need to be a little bit more careful with how he foxtrots. He foxtrots at the wrong time. He can get stock taken just like
Shingo
that.
Shingo takes another. Is he gonna go for six?
He is gonna go for six. If I know Shingo, he is gonna try to go for six as hard as possible. Oh, Raptor boost, no juffle.
Yeah, good side B there. Mally, though, kind of going really heavy on the aerials. Once again, kind of the same thing with Closer Meatball, is he's not looking for those efficient early percent combos. He's going a lot for smash attacks, one-off aerials here and there.
Yeah, he does. On the other side, Shingo has to be really careful. He's been spamming the shoulder buttons pretty heavily, so if he gets red on the roll, if he gets roll red, this could be it for Shingo.
Yeah, he does have to watch out. That Raptor boost is going to start killing soon.
Oh, yes. Oh, the foot on that. Oh, he reads
slick.
Nice tech chase from Shingo.
Pivot grab is a great option to choose because it catches you if you're still shielding, and it also catches you if you went for the spot dodge. That's some old school Brawl stuff right there.
Oh, yeah, and we saw that right there. He gets caught on the spot dodge. And now Shingo with an advantage. This could be it!
Oh, he hits the counter!
Woo!
He doesn't get the spike, but he takes the stock. Shingo takes six stocks, and he still has one in the bag. This man knows how to play to win. Oh, my God. Six stocks from their first player. Don't mess with Shingo. He's back, baby.
How deep does this roster go?
Oh, my God.
They have to deal with so many more people if somebody...
Nah. Shingo.
Just Shingo.
It's all Shingo all day right now. Let's go.
100 years of Shingo. Oopsie.
Oh, my God.
Oopsie needs to bring it back.
Come
and
back
need to
in
bring
10
it back.
Years. Oh, my God. Let's go, Shingo. This man is on fire.
DMG is going off right now.
I got to say, DMG on hype.
DMG on hype.
That's their phrase, man. That's their go-to saying.
All right. It looks like...
That's
Oopsie.
The language of their people. DMG on hype. I love Oopsie. You guys have a chance to bring this back. But you got to deal with the beast.
I got to chalk this one up to Shingo just going ham.
Come back in 10 years.
More ham than a Thanksgiving dinner with no turkey.
God. No turkey.
No turkey, just ham.
Wrap it up. We're going home. That's the tournament, guys. Thanks for watching.
I mean, if he plays like this, we could definitely be seeing him later.
If he takes one more stock, I'll be way over impressed. I'm already impressed.
Yeah.
You beat two people with three stocks.
Hey, champ, if you're out there, Shingo Saga.
Yeah, Shingo Saga.
We fit train around Robin, please. I would love to see that.
Hey. All right.
Now, we didn't get
Jafar.
To talk about this. Yep, Jafar.
I think they took a step up the ladder, you know?
Yeah, they did.
Jafar, powerful Yoshi player. He has some weaknesses, but when he goes in, he's got that Yoshi swag. Like, he's going to take the step.
Well, technically, he's going to take two stocks right here because he's going to SD. I remember every time I've seen Jafar play, he's gotten a little bit better. He's gotten closer and closer. But, all right, we're getting started over here. Game three, Jafar versus Shingo. Oh, sorry, that was terrible of me. Let me reset that. Crew battle, 9-13. That's not a lie. Nobody made a typo.
Nope.
Shingo has taken six stocks.
Yes. Yes, he has. And he's working on number seven right now. 30% lead. I really like how he used the soccer ball right there. Or volleyball.
Oh, my goodness.
No! He took seven stocks!
Seven stocks!
He took seven stocks! No!
He's at 26%.
Oh, my God. This is not real. That was so fast.
Yeah, you just caught him with the up smash for no reason.
Oh, my God. Is it really just Shingo out here right now?
I mean, he's in between games. He reset that stock. He's at 0%.
Are you sure that they didn't all just fuse into Shingo?
Oh, no!
Oh, my God. Jafar. That up B saving his life. He had already used his second jump. Jafar's got Shingo at 75%. It's definitely doable for Jafar. But he has got to watch out. Shingo, he's got so much momentum.
Oh, my goodness, he does. He's feeling it right now. Oh, I thought he was going to feel it a little bit more. He gets the dirt spike. Oh.
79%. We saw his up smash kill at 99% after the up smash damage.
Yes. And all right here. Can
okay,
get the shield?
Trying to use the jabs that would put him in the ground.
The jab one, deceptively, like, if you're not used to that, you're not gonna, you're gonna get hit by the foot.
Gonna throw it. Oh, he tried to get the spike right there.
Oh, okay, so he's rolling off the ledge to the right. That's gonna get red. That pounds.
Oh my god,
so
Shingo's trying to bait him in. Okay, Jafar gets the dash attack. 130%. That is a lot of rage. Oh my god, Shingo!
Can this be it?
No, no.
Oh my god.
No. I was so scared. Okay. Jab to F smash. Shingo almost takes 8 stocks. Oh my lord.
I can't even talk. This is because how close that 8th stock was to coming. I would have absolutely lost it if
everyone in NorCal is about to have a pocket Wii Fit trainer. Everyone's about to have a pocket Wii Fit trainer.
Do you happen to know a record on how many stocks a single person has taken in a crew battle? That might be up there. That
is up there. I think 8.
8?
It might be 8.
All right, so Evo this year rather, Napster took 18 stocks in a crew battle from what I heard. So that's an unofficial one though. So all right.
Yeah,
what did
she
send
out? I said she.
She.
Napster, that was at Evo in a hotel room against other NorCal players, and everybody was way drunk. So.
But still, all right. Okay, let's go. We've got Kato.
Alex, do you have a napkin? I need a napkin.
Use my jacket?
No. Please. Okay. So, number two to come in, my brother and friend, Kato.
Everyone's NorCal's favorite Falco. NorCal's most hyped Falco for sure. There's not even close.
Nobody comes close.
Nobody comes close to NorCal. And this, I mean, if Jafar was a step up, Kato is like an elevator ride up. Not from Shingo, but just in terms of difficulty.
He can be pretty difficult.
He said earlier that he is going to odd shot every member of Oopsie tonight.
Oh my god.
He wants to feel it, and he wants a style on these guys like it's nothing. And, you know, if he gets his way, he will.
Oh, my God. All right. We are going over to Smashville. Kato, the calm intensity.
2, 1, go!
There we go.
Oh, get man, he's just going to go through the front. Hands off my bread. Come on, do hands off my bread. Ah, no bread. All right, going straight to a laser.
All right, so now there is a gigantic lead for DMG. So this safety cushion can be used if Kato were to get 3 stock right here. Ooh, an unnecessary illusion, I think.
Oh, my God. He ended up getting the dare spike. They're trading blows right now, but Jafar is getting away with the damage lead.
And I feel like this is the most hype crowd I've ever seen, like, for DFG.
Oh my god, is he really?
Why?
Don't taunt to get bodied, please.
This is not Lilac. Can't get the taunt activation.
Yeah.
Like that.
I really hope he goes to Lilac just for that reason. Okay, Kato back on stage. He's taking a good amount of percent. Jafar's taking this away. Yep. Gets the down B. There goes the first stock off of Kato.
Well, talk about that safety cushion. They bit a little bit into it, and Jafar coming up big right now. Great aerial combo.
That's the problem with this matchup is that your man Yoshi can really eat up the combo food that is Falco.
And Kato's definitely going to have to show at least a little bit of respect right now. Otherwise, he is going to get... Oh, no! Oh, another taunt! What is up with taunts today? These guys...
They're really going in, dude. No holds barred.
This is what we need in NorCal, honestly.
Oh, yeah.
We need some of this right now. The disrespect is real. Kato goes for the down air read again. Doesn't get it.
He's going to have a hard time being that this is Yoshi. There's a lot of armor there. Okay, goes for the side beat. Down smash. Doesn't look like it's going to be enough. Jafar saved his jump. Kato can't catch this kill just yet.
Oh, he could have gone for the read there. Oh, sorry, the smash there, but he didn't get the read.
Kato gets the up smash.
There we go. Kato gets
hands
the up
off my bread. Let's go.
Oh, my
goodness. He gets the dare, but super low percent, also armor. Yoshi's not going anywhere. Kato's got to be really careful. Jafar pulls out that armor one time, that could be the end of a stock. Kato gets an extra laser. Oh! Stuffs that forward smash. Frame advantage.
I seriously thought he was going to be able to finish the jab combo there. Nice way to catch the illusion and the Firebird.
Ooh, I'm very surprised Jafar didn't just go for a fair right there. There was so much hit stun. 150%. We all know what Rage can do in this game.
Oh, yes. The comeback mechanic that Sakurai decided to add into this game. And Kato just going for those, going for that mash right there. Oh, the fair takes it. That felt a little, like, that whole stock felt a little unnecessary. Just because it could have ended a long time ago, but Kato did a really good job holding on right there.
That smash puts in some work, but oh, he's doing it again!
Hands off my bread.
This man is
hands off my bread.
Continuously taunting. He's like, come in. Come and get me. See me in the streets.
Hey, there we go. All right, this might be it. If Kato can get one more smash read.
Oh, he did not get the tech. Ooh. Kato is in danger of losing the stock right here. Oh, there's the down smash. Luckily, that forward smash missed. Kato putting in all the disrespect.
The disrespect will continue until morale improves. And all right, so Oopsie down to their final two members. I believe, A-Thug is on the roster. I remember seeing that he couldn't go, but he's here. So I don't know if they officially swapped him out. Yeah, me too.
I hope he gets to go up. But there are still two more players to go through on Oopsie.
We've yet to see Passion. We've yet to see A-Thug. And it's going to be Passion coming up. All right, so he hasn't been – I can't remember the last time he was on stream. I can't remember the last time he was at Foundry. But they're putting him in, you know, near the end for a reason. So we're going to see what Passion
has to show you guys tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see the fire in his heart, the passion in his –
Pika
in his chew. Here we go. We're going to see. There's still three stocks left for Oopsie to catch up to DMG. So, I mean, if Passion goes in, this could get evened out very, very fast. We're going to see what Kato is capable of. They are going to FD for this game.
Go!
Ladies and gentlemen, Oopsie versus DMG. All that Passion has to do is take this stock. Take one stock.
Okay, yeah, it's already started. Kato versus Passion. And Pikachu can put in some work on Falco. Not a great matchup for your boy Falco.
You know,
off
really
stage is not safe. On stage can be very difficult with a very strong combo game, but Kato's the one putting in work right now.
I mean, I was going to say, feels like Passion might feel like he can beat Kato in at least one stock because he chose FD. And the combo game for Pika's going to have to be a little bit on point if he wants to take the stock.
All right, Kato making it back. Passion tried to get him with the jab. Oh, he does it again! Taunting it bodied every time. Like, he's three hits going over to Passion.
He can't spend that much time taunting. He can't spend that much time jabbing. And Passion, okay, so around this percent is when...
Ooh, it hurt, but he did not get the meteor.
It's going to start to hurt a little bit later on.
Kato's straight going in right now. Looks like Kato's going to take another shot and stock unless Passion pulls it together a bit.
I mean, he's trying to crouch cancel everything over the down tilt.
Oh,
he's going to take it.
There it is. Kato taking another stock here, keeping his team in the lead, 5-10.
Ooh, okay. Do you think we're going to see? Okay.
That is a kill. Kato loses a stock down to 9. Passion has 2 stocks left, and then their last player, probably a thug, is going to be holding on to 3. Kato did not put in crazy work. He kind of just taunted and hit them a bit. But Shingo has kept a 5-stock lead on this team. So.
Shingo.
Oh, no. This is going to be so hard.
Okay. It's Kirby.
Myro is dummy good at this game. He just is. Yeah. I met Myro in the PM era, and he was dummy good at that game, too. And now, this man is about to go in on DMG. I don't know what's going to happen, man. What's going to happen.
All right. I don't know this guy very well, so I am super excited.
Myro's terrifying, bro.
All right.
Listen
I believe
to me.
You. I believe you.
Myro's going to kill Zyles. In the game. No, he's really good. He's sleeper amazing.
Sleeper amazing.
Pictures.
He's not underage, is he?
If I look over here continuously, will they not take pictures?
I honestly don't see him that often.
What, Myro?
No,
he's not around very much.
Does he come to Foundry often? Is he underage?
No.
Okay. He just probably doesn't do much stuff.
He just doesn't come out all that much. When he does, holy shit. It's me. Right.
Yeah, I'm just kind of showing how new I am. But, all right. So he's one of the rare Kirby mains. We've got a few Kirby mains in NorCal that I know of. M3 and Snorlax come to mind. And if you're telling me he's a beast, he's a monster, I expect great things out of this guy.
No hate to the other two. Myro's better than both.
Sorry?
Myro's better than them both.
Yeah.
Like, if he's playing up to the caliber that he usually does, like if he hasn't just been completely not playing at all whatsoever, he's going to be pretty scary.
All right.
Now that I've talked about Myro, better not flop down, dog. I give you so much praise. Passion, though. Let's see if he can really get something going here, dude.
Okay. All right, so I think Myro just feeling Passion out right now, trying to read on some of his tendencies.
Yeah.
Once he gets a download on that, I feel like he's going to start showing off how much you're hyping him up.
Right now, I mean, what I like is that it's a small person matchup. They can both hit each other pretty easily. Kirby can be hard to hit sometimes. Pikachu, too.
Especially when they're both crouching. This is looking incredibly even right now. This stock. Okay.
This does not look super easy at all.
Even.
Yeah.
Ooh.
This doesn't look easy for either of them.
Right here. So, I mean, what?
Oh, my God.
This could be the start of something.
Oh, my God. Don't do it. That's a way to get your opponent moving for sure.
Oh, yeah. I feel like that's better than taunting.
Yes. I would agree. I'd say that just about any attack is better than taunting. Good back air right there. Myro taking the lead here. Putting down the damage. Trying to cover that 2-frame, but Passion goes high. Jab, jab. Nice snare right there from Passion, but he doesn't get a follow-up on that.
I feel like he's going to try to pull out the mallet to finish the stock just for the style points. Oh, okay.
Yeah, Myro's taking a bit for that. A little 2-piece of damage. Pikachu's really good at spacing the same way that Kirby is, kind of. Having a lot of different angles to go through.
I don't think I've ever seen that before.
Oh, my God. Didn't matter. You can call lightning from the skies. Myro does not care. Going for the forward air.
Okay, there we go.
Oh, gets the down air into the up tilt. The combo begins, and there it ends for now. Oh, he needed that.
He needed that so hard. He was about to get sent to the Shadow Realm right there. And Myro, okay, showing off why he's touted so highly by UDC.
Lots of damage right there for Passion, though. Mario snaps the ledge. Now he has a great tool for neutral to end up dealing with Pikachu.
Not as if Mario wasn't having that.
Oh! Another stock! Mario loses no stocks!
And you see the pop off right there. He's like, yeah, I'm back. I'm here. It's not just Kato and Shingo. It's Mairo, too.
Oh, my God.
My God. Are we talking about Kato putting people on odd shots? Mairo. Mairo is going to put somebody on an odd shot right now.
This man is going in. I'm so excited to see him play again, dude. I haven't seen him in so long.
Oh, my goodness.
Don't sleep on Kirby. Great character in this game.
That was the hardest.
Let's go.
Hardest legendary.
Ooh, it's a thug.
All right. This is it. This is it for Oopsie. Oopsie can't pull this out. A-Thug has nine stocks to go. This is the tallest order. He can afford to lose one per three stocks.
We've had so many crew battles in NorCal, and most of them have come down to the last stock, or at least the last four. This, if Mairo wins right now, it's going to be slaughter.
Yes.
I want to see these guys at each other's throats in tournament from here on out. This had better be like whenever Oopsie comes up against DMG in tournament, they're going to be like out for blood. Like, let's go.
It's it. Competition. This is competition. This isn't practice.
This is scary.
I want memes. I want
You want
assault.
Memes?
I want so much to come out of this. I want so much to come out of this crew battle just because that fire, I feel like needs to get lit under more people, you know?
Needs to get lit.
It needs to get more lit.
It needs
here.
To get haystack, man.
Wait, hey, shout out
lit.
To haystacks. All right. A-Thug needs to prepare himself. I feel like he needs a minute.
This looks like a rap battle. It really does. Mario looks like he's a street rapper. A thug looks like he's signed on a label. He makes trap. Mario makes conscious trip hop.
He wears the Kirby shirt, ironically.
Oh my God, this is going to be crazy. Okay, Mario's going to have to chase this man down hard because you are playing against Toon Link, a character that is going to run away. He's going to throw bombs, gonna throw a bunch of stuff, and Kirby can swallow it or shield, but he can't swallow everything without taking damage. I mean, he can't swallow bombs without them exploding, right?
No, I think he has to grab them. All right. Three, two, 21 Savage. Go! You're talking about A-Thug being a trap musician.
Hey.
I mean, this is it. This is it for Oopsie. If they lose this, it's all over. It's all order for A-Thug. They're getting right into it here on Battlefield. I like this choice. Alternatively, I could have seen Town and City, but we're going to see what A-Thug can do with the platforms here on Battlefield. All those bomb shenanigans going on right now.
Yeah, Mairo's taking a little bit of damage here. A big stage like this, Toon Link has a lot of space to run around.
Every single percentage at this point matters for the thug. Because if he can't safely rack up damage, rack up kills, he's not going to be able to come back from this. And Mairo already putting on some good work. Nice perfect shield to get the item grab.
Still pretty close so far, but this is probably going to be the longest match that we've seen, through this crew battle.
Oh, yeah, and that's just the nature of this matchup. Toon Link alone is capable of stalling the game out.
Oh, there
so
it
hard.
Is. First stock taken. First stock taken. A thug, one stock down. You cannot go off stage without being prepared for that down air.
No, you can't. And as we saw right there, he got punished absolutely very hard for. Nice free grab off the perfect shield right here. And Mairo's perfect game shield has been on point. He's at 102%, but still, this feels like Mairo's game right now.
I mean, a thug still has to come in. Oh, is he getting put off stage again? Is he going to do a back throw? Yep.
Oh, my goodness.
Yep, trying to cover a lot of space there.
like that would have spiked if he had landed it, but can't be sure. But
Myro is in control of this game so far. He's closing that percent gap. A Thug is moving a little more hastily. Myro's just trying to continuously get a Thug into a corner so he can either get a hit or push this man off stage.
And a nice pummel to the down throw. That down throw has been, the throw game has been super important for Myro. He's letting him get just percentage for basically free. Ooh, reads that.
Ooh.
Oh,
so
close.
Ends up killing, yeah. Myro probably threw something out. But Myro doesn't have to worry about his stocks going away here. He just has to worry about catching a Thug. Because Myro has two more crew members to deal with two more stocks. If it even gets that far, because a Thug is at pretty high percent right now. Oh, no.
Oh, no. Oh, my
Don't
goodness.
Do it.
I just saw it come like this. No. Oh, my goodness.
Good Lord. Terror in our hearts. Myro's starting to get caught by these bombs as a Thug covers the space where he runs away. Throwing out these bombs at some good angles.
Oh,
Done. That is it.
All right, one stock left.
Is Myro going to clean up with, what, four stocks on his plate?
Four stocks.
This is nuts.
Well, I mean, you don't need that much. And this jab combo looking incredibly clean. Myro's game looking incredibly on point today. Gets the item grab. Can he use the bomb to his advantage?
Already, it is looking very good for DMG. Myro is staying right in a Thug's face, getting in some good damage. A Thug responds with a little bit of damage of his own. He's gonna need to take out a stock here, but he's gonna need a lot more percent for that to happen. He put himself in a kind of interesting situation with his stage choice.
Oh, I thought he was gonna get the read with an up air right there, but Myro. Myro!
Oh my God!
Myro, what? What?
No! 100 pounds on your head!
Ah, oh my God. I can't even handle that right now. Myro with the hypest three stocks of the night
Shingo
so far.
Shingo takes seven. Kato takes three. Myro takes four.
That's GG. That is GG.
That's it.
Oopsie.
That's it.
Is done. They made an oopsie challenging DMG tonight. You look very apprehensive right now.
I have not seen a crew battle so one-sided in all of NorCal Smash 4 history. That's it.
That's it.
Good Lord.
And what a note to end on.
Oh, indeed,
100
man.
Pounds of fury.
Shout-outs to DMG. Shout-outs to Oopsie. DMG just...
DMG...
What's Shingo went in with seven stocks. I was like, if they lose, it's not going to happen. It's just not going to happen. You have so many more powerful players coming up.
We didn't even get to see two of them. That's just how it goes.
Yo, did Myro take five? No. Kato took four as well?
Yeah.
Okay.
Kato
took four.
So it's Shingo took
seven.
Seven.
Kato took four. Myro took four.
Yeah. Because that's 15. We do math here.
Good Lord.
Good Lord. I'm blown away.
Yeah.
And if that's how well Myro plays when he's rusty.
I'm telling you, dude.
I am terrified to see what he's going to pull out
tonight.
Don't
play against Myro.
Just don't.
So, everyone, that was just the precursor. That was
the appetizer.
To this amazing tournament we are about to have, because Smash of the Titans number 8 is about to go